Hey guys, Angus here from Pegasus PT. Just to make a quick little video today to talk to you guys a little bit about balance with your training and hopefully give you guys a bit of an indicator on any areas in your training that are letting you down so you can be injury free and get the best results possible. So to start with, I'm going to use an analogy we're probably all familiar with, which is the fire triangle. So I'm sure we've all seen this at school. You've got your fire in the middle, it's a pretty awesome fire. And so the fire needs three things to survive. It needs fuel, it needs oxygen, and it needs heat. So we all know, if you take one of these things away, if you take the fuel away, the fire's gonna burn out, it's not gonna survive. If you take the oxygen away, the fire's gonna starve. And if you take the heat away, it's also gonna collapse. So any one of these three things, if they're not in balance, then the structure collapses. So I'm gonna take the same analogy, but I'm gonna put you, the human body, inside. So in order for the human body to grow and perform and to act optimally, there's a few things that need to be in balance. In terms of exercise, we need, you got your stress. So exercise is a form of stress. You need to be stressing your body so that it adapts and overcomes the stress and comes back stronger. You need fuel. Fuel for the body is in nutrition. So you've given it the stress, you need to build back, but you need to give it the building blocks that it requires to come back stronger. And the third thing that your body needs is rest. So you've given it the stress, you've given it the fuel, but now it needs time to take that fuel and build back stronger. So that's the three things the body needs in order to adapt, to grow, to be operating at optimal capacity. And just like the fire, if you take one of these things away or they're out of balance, then the structure in the middle isn't going to be as good as it can be. So there's a few common things that you see happen with most people in their training and exercise. I guess the general population, the number one thing is that people are getting enough rest, they're getting enough fuel, but they're not getting enough exercise. And so that's why you see the obesity level in Australia so high. People are resting, they're sedentary, they're laying down, they're not doing much, so the rest is through the roof. They're eating a lot, they're eating a lot of shitty foods, so they're definitely getting enough fuel, but they're not exercising, they're not moving. So as a result, you get a big, fat, slow, sick, and injured structure in the middle, which is the human body. That's the first thing. The second thing, you see people, they're being fit and healthy, so they're getting the training down. They're doing lots of training, they're exercising, they're lifting in the gym every week. They're getting fuel, they're sometimes not the right things, but they are getting fuel in. So they're exercising and they're eating, but they're not resting. So they're giving the body the stress it needs, they're doing some damage to the tissue, and they're eating it, they're giving the body the building blocks it needs, but they're not taking the time off in order to rebuild, to come back stronger. So it's a very common thing you see in the gym. People overtraining, they think they need to get in, they need to go as hard as they can, for as long as they can to get the best results. It's not true, because you've got your three pillars here, rest isn't there, the structure falls over, so you end up injuring yourself. The third thing is, so we've had too much food, too much rest, we've had too much stress. Yes, third thing. So we've got the stress, we've got the training. The training's happening, it's going on. Everyone's being super active. They're getting the rest, they're taking some time off, but they're not getting enough fuel, they're not giving the building blocks that they need. This is something you see, I think, a lot of time, people who need to lose weight. They're training, they're running every day, they're going to the gym, they're giving themselves a lot of stress. They're getting rest at night, they're resting, but they're not eating. They're eating for fat loss. They think they have to starve themselves to get results. And again, the structure's gonna fall over. You're gonna get sick, you're gonna get injured. Because if you're not giving yourself the building blocks you need to recover, your body is gonna get that energy from somewhere. That means your muscles are gonna break down, your tissues are gonna break down, your emotions are gonna break down. So we need to make sure we're getting enough fuel. So that's commonly three things we see with training. Hope that video helps. So just like the fire, take the fuel away, the oxygen away, or the heat away, the fire collapses. With the body, if you're not resting enough, take the rest away, you get sick and injured. If you take the fuel away, you're not going to be rebuilding, coming back optimally, you've run the risk of being sick or injured. And if you take the stress away, then you're going to get fat and sick. I hope that helped, guys. I hope it cleared things up a little bit, or sort of showed you how, any areas in your training that you're lacking in or you need to bring back into balance. If you have any questions, just pop a comment below. And if you think anyone could benefit from this, just like or share. Thanks, guys. Have a ripper week. Angus out.